Hello one and all, and welcome back to Let's Play Empyrion Galactic Survival with me, EkkiThump. You rejoin me on the base at the roof of our base on Akua, where I'm just working out the dents in the wood that somehow are caused by minigun fire. It's a video game abstraction. We'll work with it, it's fine. Some here as well. Today we are mostly ripping down structures, I think, because we've hit level 15. It's time to get some stuff together for the capital ship. So let's have a look in the factory, see where we are. G2 Scryer, was it? Don't we have something in the factory already? Yeah, we do. Right, so we know ore can't go in there. Wait a minute. Did I pick up a core from the chests last time? I must have done. I'm pretty sure I don't need both of them. I'll keep one handy, I guess. Or maybe not. Fuck it. Put the core in there as well. So we're going to go through... Is there a dent on the floor there? Am I imagining it? I guess I'm imagining it. We're going to go through the stuff here. Sort everything out. See what we can chuck away. Not chuck away. Put into the factory, and then we're going to go and get the rest of what we need either from the neodymium mines on the moon or from ripping down outposts here on Akua. Depends. Look at all this spoiled food. Such waste. So these do not contribute to blueprint production, so they're going to have to go into storage. Concrete and so forth. I'll put the epic guns away because I haven't really got the stuff I need to make ammunition for them, and I'm probably just going to hang on to the pulse rifle for now. Not that I seem to have a great deal of ammo for. What the fuck? Do I have no. Oh, it's all in the pulse rifle. Yeah, so there's no point really hanging on to the epic assault rifle either. And the epic shotgun will just stay in there for now. So medical crap goes in there temporarily. Hydrogen fuel goes into the constructor. We might as well put some white O2 bottles in cargo. So we're looking for stuff we can scrap, like this food processor that I can go indefinitely. These tier 1 assault rifles, we don't need to hang on to those things anymore. Yeah, pistols, rifles, blocks of steel, truss, combat steel, very good, O2 tanks, light blocks, hardened steel blocks, doors, elevators, large generators, offline protection unit, we're not going to need that at all ever, more guns, hangar doors, drop that all in. In the last playthrough I did test whether it was worth actually using raw materials, crafting them up into components and then putting them in, but you don't get the full amount of time back. It's actually, if you don't have stuff just in general to throw into the factory, it's actually fine to just use iron bars, because the time it takes to turn, like, say raw iron and silicon or whatever into a computer is longer than the time you get back from putting them, the computers, then into the workshop. We've tested that in season 1 at some point. Okay, we've got 1,000 iron so far. We've still got stuff to dispose of. Yeah, the flashlight can go in. Oh no, we want to hang on to one drill and one chainsaw. These are our sort of absolute backup tools. If everything goes completely tits up, then we can come back to Akua, get a drill, get some seaweed, get some biofuel, and restart from scratch if we need to. Fuel packs want to keep, but all of these things can go in. Got a couple of spare cannon turrets. Yeah, let's put them in. I do have something I need cannon turrets for. Ooh. Possibly need more growing plots, not sure. Armoured window blocks. Right, texture tool and colour tool will hang on to. 50 small truss blocks and repair bay. We might need some plastic raw material in there, so let's take those deco blocks and check. Right, so that's all the rubbish out of the cargo boxes. No, we're fine on plastic now. We do still need some growing plots. There we go. Right, so hardened steel, repair bay, truss, windows, guns, two large constructors, that's very good, very good return on those. Fridge, water generator, small ammo box, some steel, some windows, flashlight, yeah. Tier 3 fuel tank, generator, fuel tank. That's everything out of there. Now let's start working on some of the components that we've got in here. So hardened steel plates, they're going to help. Metal pieces, advanced CPUs, flux coils, yes, definitely. Steel plates, components, reactor cores, control devices, motors. All this. We'll leave the actual raw bars for now. I have a feeling we're going to need to at least throw in some Arrestrium and Zascosium. But we'll see how much we can get of the rest. Look, we're nearly there on copper. Only 85 more of that to go. We're way over on copper now, actually. Yeah, so over on copper that we don't need to put the cables in anymore. Steel plates, though. Hardened steel plates. We still need a lot of sathium. If we still need a lot of sathium, one thing we might do is go back to the abandoned mine. Because I believe the walls there are made out of hardened steel blocks, so if we can steal those, that'll get us plenty of sathium. So largely it's little bits and pieces here and there, but the neodymium we can get from the moon. Assuming we don't find any while ripping down the base. You know, we might go straight back to the abandoned mine. Possibly. Which we could try taking down one of the outposts first. Let's put these back in there. Okay, yeah, they can just live there, whatever. Okay, so that's all our stuff. All our stuff ransacked. Anything left in these cargo bays? There shouldn't be, but it's worth checking. There's some meat. Gotta remember to put the meat in the fridge. Actually, I might as well transfer all this over. I'll leave a bunch of oxygen bottles. The rest of it we need to transfer inside. What about box 2? Anything there? Nothing there. What about the cargo box on this thing? It's been a while. No, empty. Wait a minute. That's the harvest box. Where's the actual cargo box? Some stuff. It's not going to finish the job, but it'll contribute. Sniper rifle. Let's keep the sniper rifle for now. 12 gauge shells. Hang on to. Cobalt, magnesium, powder. Promethium ore, yeah. Iron and copper. Some silicon. That goes in the fridge. I think these go in the food processor, maybe. Water jug might as well go in there. Fridge is nearly full, which is a good thing. Bandages, spoiled food. We need to make some space, really. We need to leave some stuff behind. Okay, we'll drop some 9mm ammo off first of all. And if we're not taking the shotgun, we don't need the. Are we taking a shotgun? No, let's not take the shotgun. In fact, let's reprocess this crappy shotgun because we've got an epic one now. Boom. Right. that's all of that. Let's start off at the outpost. The large outpost. Oh, have we claimed the large outpost? Claimed the small one, we haven't claimed the large one. Damn it. Did I put both those cores in the factory? Or have I put one in the box? Son of a bitch. Okay, well we need to go and claim that place, otherwise we can't rip blocks off it. So okay, give me a core, I guess. Let's see then. Should be in. Wait a minute, haven't we claimed this place? Did we not put a core down? Did we just shoot the core out? We must have. I don't know now. Let's have a look. Oh, steady, 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 steady. Boom. Yeah, we have. We've claimed the place. Right. Let's begin. We're gonna start with this power tower where the core is. Is that a good idea? Maybe we should start at the other side. We'll reclaim our core last. Okay, so I want to disassemble. Hold on. Oh, I think actually I might need to set this. Yeah, that's right. I need to set this to private. Now it shows up as mine and I get actual blocks back. Which does matter because they'll take more time off the construction process. So I hope everyone's looking forward to Alpha 6. Oh, fuck it, waste of materials. Not too many, it's fine. I definitely am. As I've said before, I'm really liking the look of those alien patrol ships. They look well designed, and I'm hearing from like people playing, because Alpha 6 is out now on the experimental branch. Like getting it ready for prime time. And people are saying they're having a blast. So I'm not sure what's in it, other than... Ooh, some Prometheum. Other than the patrol ships. Fucking hell, I did a really poor job of looting this place. I'm not sure if patch 6 is where the armour comes in. But that's definitely a feature to look forward to. I know that's... I can't remember exactly why I think this, but I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be really imminent. And I'm interested to see what they've done with it. Whether it's just protection or whether there is the kind of utility armour that I was hoping for as well. It's just another layer to the game. Like Empyrion many moons ago was a game that obviously had potential but felt quite basic and empty around sort of alpha, sort of early alpha 4, late alpha 3, that sort of period. But I mean, it's amazing when you think of it just how much they've managed to add to the game. I mean, these places, these are very new, these are very late alpha 5, and the way they've been able to add so much into the game without causing like crippling bugs all the time. I mean, obviously it's been annoying sort of here and there with the issues with like recording in OBS, like having to do it by display capture, which is, they're issues that don't really persist that long, and they're not gameplay issues. God, am I going to need more multi-tool charges here? Maybe so. Yeah, it's surprising how stable the game is. I mean, sometimes you literally forget you're playing an alpha because everything just works so well. It's only really a slight lack of features still. Like the obvious gaps, the fact that they have all these slots and like O2 tank slot not active yet. But I mean, most people have sort of forgotten this side of the inventory screen exists for now, apart from the XP bar. God, there's more stuff I didn't loot. Not that we need a great deal of wood, obviously. Ah, some spectators. Come to watch, have you? I like your villages, by the way. Yeah, the one sort of change I obviously haven't been that thrilled with is the way that base assaults seem to have become sort of much harder. It feels like they've kind of they fixed the glitch where like Xerax could only shoot in a like circular plane around the level of their gun. They've sort of solved that a bit. And now it's like playing like old Perfect Dark on the like Super Nintendo 64, I want to say. I'm pretty sure it wasn't a SNES game. But basically just like playing a first person shooter against perfect bots. So that's... God damn it, that's the next thing I really hope they work on. I mean, variety would be nice, but it would be nice to see a downgrade for the enemies, possibly. And obviously I still think there's more they could do with the survival aspect of the game, because it is still very much, you know, set up your farm and then whatever. It is Empyrion Galactic survival. And all the stuff they've added is not really survival-ish. Even in this mode, it's mostly annoying, to be honest, that I just keep running out of... Keep running out of like iron or whatever. It's more survival-y. What's really still missing, though, is that sense that the universe is out to get you. See, that's my thing with survival games, because it's potentially a very broad category, and if like the word survival sort of threatens to become a bit like the word roguelike, you know, it doesn't mean anything. My definition of a survival game would be one where it feels like you're in a struggle against the environment to survive, which is something that Empyrion doesn't quite deliver. The planets, some of them look a bit more hostile. Obviously, this is like, you know, Green Hill Zone, Paradise Planet. But even on a planet like Atis, or what little we saw of Masperon is a good example. They might be lava worlds, but they don't feel any more difficult to survive on, apart from the enemies. They just feel like sort of varying backgrounds, which is not what I would really think of in a survival game. The two best, a great example of survival game I'm playing at the moment is it's a survival roguelike, but it actually is kind of a roguelike, called Unreal World, which is an Iron Age game set in Finland, and it's a game that has like no real the fuck. Okay, how is this happening? Let me just break into my little rant about survival games there. How the fuck is that? Does that think it's still connected to ground? Okay, I mean, I am the father of the floating crystal. Even that looks weird, even to me. Survival games. So, with Unreal World, it's you against the environment, essentially. It's just a struggle to, like, find food and... there go 48 shots of the multi-tool. Find food, like... survive and not die of starvation, not die of hypothermia, and that's it. That's the game. It's you trying to do that in the best way you can. That to me is a survival game. 7 days to die. Oh, time to go home. 7 days to die definitely is a survival game. Just because Not so much. I mean, there is still the issue that the trouble with survival games is always when it comes down to renewable resources, like farming. Farming is the same sort of issue in that game. It takes more effort to get the farm going, I think, in 7 Days to Die. Plus, you've got the like the hordes, which are another thing entirely. Where am I going? West. But yeah, anyway, long story short, it needs to be a bit more of an actual survival game. Well, the thing is, that's what I think, but Empyrion has gathered a large audience based off just being what it is, you know, being a more sort of creative, not so much a survival game, more like an FPS. How to say, like an FPS exploration slash creative game? And possibly, I mean, I would certainly enjoy it, but maybe it would be bad for the game if it went too far in that direction. Because, you know, I love survival games, but obviously a lot of people don't. And the game is currently so far from being a survival game that it might actually turn a lot of its current fan base off if it went too far in that direction. But anyway, any Leon we trust. I'm sure they've got a plan for what they're doing. But there is, I suppose, just that thing of like, why is food even in the game? It's so easy to get. It's just sort of a minor distraction on day one before you get into building cool spaceships. But we'll see. I mean, they could add things like hostile. They could add, you know, when we went to Skillon and it's like a horrible green eldritch place, you know, they can make the environment hazardous there or stuff like that. I suppose that's something they can only really do once they've added armor pieces in. Because then you would be able to kind of tweak your gear to survive on different planets. Who's coming where? Is this thing on? Yep, it's on. Peekaboo! Peekaboo! Thanks, I got that one. That was my kill. Right, let's drop some stuff off and then we'll go. Go back to the outpost and. Okay, I've gone blind. Right, F2. We don't need to drop anything off, do we? We're in the factory, we can do it from wherever. Ah, but I have some stuff I want to. What is this? Glass railing? Okay. Spare colour tool we don't need. We've got a chainsaw. Got some walkway blocks. Concrete, no. Hardened steel. 91 blocks of steel. Very good. Steel plate there. Cargo boxes. We're so over on copper. But this is fine. Anything that goes like over the amount we'll save in the factory for the next thing we want to do. So we're not too worried. Honestly, the real reason I'm banging on at length about survival games is just that this would be a very boring episode otherwise, because all I'm going to be doing for the next hour at least is just tearing down that outpost. So if I just did that in silence and cut it out, this episode would be just that, you know, me. I'd say let's get to it, and then 2 minutes later, I'd be standing in the midst of a half-disassembled outpost saying, "Well, that's it for this episode. See you next week." I'm not honestly that worried about genres anyway. I think genres are kind of useful as a guide for what a game is, but I think it's usually a bad idea to set out for developers to set out and say, "I'm going to make a game of this type." You know, if your game does end up fitting into the survival genre, then great. But I don't think you need to sit down and say, "Okay, I want to make a sci-fi survival game. Let's plan out how we do that." which obviously, you know, Ilion haven't done. What would you classify this game as, really? I sort of struggled when I came up with the... I've got a YouTube description for this game, and I can't remember what it says because I just copy and paste it every time I do a new episode. So I probably haven't actually read it in, like, I don't know, months. But something like sci-fi, voxel, creative, shooter, FPS. There's quite a few different things you could label it as. Which is in itself a good thing, because we always want innovation in games. What have we got? What have we got under tools? We have the tier 2 multi-tool. I'm going to have to go back for some multi-tool charges soon. Maybe we should upgrade to that. I think that would... That'll give us a bit more bang for our buck out of the charges. It'll take less hits to disassemble a block, I think. This is a very tricky little... Very tricky roof to disassemble, this one. So, Scott G was asking, what software do I use to record and edit these? Is it OBS? Yes, it is OBS. I'll do a video, I suppose, tomorrow night, Wednesday. Just, I've got to go fucking up with space now. Just showing what and how I do these. It's actually really easy. Surprisingly easy. But everything I use is freeware, or at least like, it doesn't cost anything. There is a difference. So we've got OBS for recording, which is free and open source. It's a screen capture and streaming and like screen recording, all that stuff. It's got you covered. Editing the videos, actually just do in Windows Movie Maker. Because it's free, if you're on Windows, it's not what I'd be using if I were on Linux, obviously. It's not a super powerful tool, but it does the job. Because all I really do with these videos is take a bunch of raw footage. Hello? Where am I? What the fuck? What the hell? Am I doing the hover vehicle in space thing again? Yeah, all I do is take a bunch of raw footage and edit out like stuff I don't want to be in the video, any long silences or, you know, boring parts in general. So I take about an hour, somewhere between like an hour 20 of raw footage per episode, and edit it down to, my goal is like anything between half an hour and 45 minutes. I usually go longer than that. Windows Movie Maker, it's not the best software, it's not the most fully featured, but it is good enough. If I was, because you know, I don't do some things that a lot of YouTubers do. Like I don't have anything overlaid onto the screen, which Movie Maker can't do for you unless it's like captions and stuff. So if you watch, I mean, some premium channels, like for example, like the Yogscast collaboration videos, down the left-hand side of the screen here, they've always got their little avatars. Movie Maker can't do that, but yeah, just chopping together raw footage, it's fine. Sometimes it doesn't like it and it goes a bit mental. And I have considered upgrading. But, yeah, it seems to be okay. And the only other two things I use are a program called AviDemux, which is kind of a, it's like a freeware post-processing utility. You can't really use it for editing videos, but it does like effects, filters. I use it to grab thumbnails. I use it to fix any audio sync issues, which again, Movie Maker can't do because you can't edit the sound separately in Movie Maker. So that's AviDemux. And then I use a program called GIMP, the GNU Image Manipulation Program, I think, just to basically to paste the text onto the screenshot and turn it into like a proper thumbnail. So yeah, it's not all the best software, especially Movie Maker, but it's completely free from right from the point of pressing record all the way to pressing publish. Nothing I've had to spend a single penny, cent, or drachma on. So I'll do a little bit of a video just showing how everything's set up, but honestly it's nothing fancy. I guarantee you if I could do it, you can do it. So let's unlock tier 2 multi-tool and we'll get one of those. Yep, and we'll have 6 multi-tool charges. Right, let's put the tier 1 multi-tool in the factory. And this may look like a very long-winded way of doing it, but do bear in mind we've saved ourselves already 2.5 hours on multi-tool production. On multi-tool production. Fucking hell, on capital ship production. So it'll be interesting to see how low we can get it. That's how long have I been recording now? That's about 45 minutes invested on like tearing down structures, and we've probably saved, we maybe saved half an hour on the stuff that we got from the abandoned mine when we looted the place. So I guess we'd save about another, no, 2 hours? No. Yeah, about another 2 hours for, oh. What the fuck is happening to my frame rate? Holy Jesus balls. And there's me saying how brilliant and stable and how like Empyrion is and how rarely you notice it's an alpha. To be fair, I have had that happen in full price AAA releases as well. So it is pretty par for the course. It's probably because of the sunrise and the amount of like shadows it has to recalculate and that kind of thing. There must be ways of optimizing that, because that's the kind of thing that a lot of games do, and it doesn't make them all shit the bed whenever the sun strikes a forest. I don't know. I guess that's something we'll look forward to seeing fixed in Alpha 6 point whatever. Come to think of it, actually the last time that happened to me in this game, that was around the forest as well, so I bet it is something to do with the like the dynamic position of the sun and how it interacts with the forest. Why the fuck am I don't want to be stunned in there. The cannon can take point. Fuck that, I'm not taking damage. There's another thing they could add into the game, a cover system. Imagine if I could like hide behind this block And instead of having to sidestep, take shots, step back, I could like lean around the cover. And just pot shot these little buggers. Nice rich harvest. So am I ever going to get around to doing that 7 Days to Die let's play I was talking about a while back? Ask no one in particular. Well, it's always a possibility. I mean, I wasn't really planning on doing Starbound, but I just kind of... That was... Starting the Starbound let's play was kind of serendipity, really. Because I was kind of feeling, just like in general, feeling like, oh, I've got a bit of an itch to go back and play some more Starbound. I hear it's really improved since Alpha, and it has really improved since Alpha. And then Planet Explorers decided it didn't want to work anymore on my computer. So I needed a new game to fill the void on what used to be Planet Explorers Night. And so we ended up with Let's Play Starbound instead. So will I do 7 Days to Die? I mean, I'm always, at some point I'm always going to need a new game to throw in. I've got kind of a full schedule at the moment. Because I've only actually got one night a week where I don't post videos. I suppose I could be a bit less lazy. Maybe post 2 videos on a Saturday. But come on. Come on now. Really? Me be less lazy? Okay, that's one entire building down. Let's just see where we stand. I'm actually just going to put these bars in directly. I know it's not, they don't take any time off, but whatever. So silicon. Copper we actually don't need. Cobalt we don't need anymore. Do need iron. So we've got the stairs, glass railing, no. Walkways should do, yeah. O2 station. ...148 steel blocks, takes off 6 minutes, and we're almost at 5,000 iron. What would you say? Thrown in. Installed. And there we are, there's a bit of... ...bit of that, we don't need any more deco blocks in there. LCD screens, they do count. So this was 6 hours to start with. We're now down to 3 hours 13 and we've still got a lot of materials left to throw in. Maybe we should visit the abandoned Titan wreck instead of the abandoned mine. I'm sure there are still a few thrusters hanging around. If we could claim the Titan wreck, we'd get some neodymium off that as well. Maybe even some zascosium and irestrum from power coils in various capital ship bits, if we can track any more down. There's at least one part of the Titan we haven't touched yet. I think it was the front part? Question mark? Yeah, over here. There's the comm center we claimed, and there's the MS Titan front part. There's a mid part around somewhere, but that tends to be less... Well, it tends to have cargo boxes, but it doesn't have like cap ship components in it, really. I think it's the front part might be the one we want. Let's finish up here first. I'm trying to get up there so I can dismantle these first. Oh! What the fuck was that? Oh, that's a cheeky little technique. They look like they're planted on that. Oh, I see what's happening here. So this walkway block is providing support to this walkway. And these are either hanging off the side of this or hanging off of that. Yeah. Clever. We didn't want those railings anyway. Now, how exactly is this staying up? I guess. Right, so this window is occupying this voxel up here, this sort of area of space there, and then this walkway is kind of in the voxel that it's on top of. So I bet if I take out this window, yeah, there goes that walkway. It's just interesting to see how all this crap fits together. It's the same sort of effect that we used in the Imperial Senate, but obviously they didn't go out of their way to make things look like they were floating. It just so happens that things are arranged so that they do float when you start ripping bits of the base away. Oh. Sadly, it does make it a little bit unpredictable as to what's going to fall down when. That was not unpredictable, that was just stupid. But a steel block here or there won't make much of a difference. We are heading for about 9,000 more iron. Oh, fuck! That was the wrong block to take out. It's kind of sad when you think of it, all the effort that someone put into designing this base, and here we are just ripping it apart to melt down for raw materials. But there is another one on this planet. The large outpost actually won't cease to exist in this universe, even after we do this. Right, how are we doing now then? Definitely proceeding at a decent pace. Pushing up on 6,000 iron. Oh, and there's the halfway mark, 3 hours to go. I think at this point, I'm going to stop taking this place apart and go to the abandoned mine. Because, most of what we need now, apart from these like a few advanced bits and pieces, which we're probably not going to get from this place, is iron and sathium. In other words, hardened steel blocks, which I do believe the abandoned mine is made from. So now I have been recording for an hour, and I don't think we're going to get the capture ship deployed this episode. So I'm going to probably call a halt to this one here. Next time we'll tear down the abandoned mine. We'll get some stuff from there. Honestly, I probably could have just not done this episode, but that would mean not getting a video out tonight. I could have done this off camera, but the thing is, I don't really want to do this off camera because... what the fuck am I going? I'm going without the noob truck. I don't want to do this off camera because... A, I feel like it's important to show like the quantity of materials you can expect from doing this as kind of a guide for the viewer. Secondly, that I'm not just spawning it all in from the cheat menu, because some of you may not know, some of you more delicate souls, if that's the right expression, may not know, but this game does have a creative menu in the main game. Like the one you get in the Minecraft, where you can just give yourself shit. Which I have never used. I've not generally never used it in the Let's Play, but... Yeah, so I don't want people getting the idea that maybe I've just used that. Plus, it's as well as the amount of materials you can get from that thing, it's also like a useful... useful for the viewer to see how long it takes to gather this kind of crap. So that was like an hour's work to get that much of the base down, and it's roughly an hour's work, and it saved us about 2.5 hours of production time on our CV, which is a decent investment because there wasn't a great deal else we were going to do with that time. But yep, I will call it here. Next episode will probably be much the same. It'll be us flying out to the abandoned mine, doing a bit of disassembly, flying back, taking out drones, rinse, repeat, until we get enough stuff to spawn in our lovely big new capital ship. But that'll be it for this episode. So, do hope you've enjoyed it. Like and subscribe if you would like to see more gameplay of Empyrion Galactic Survival. I've been EkkiThump, and I will see you next time.